हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ई क्लासेस ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय पूर्णचंद्र हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल बारीपदा मयूरभंज। फॉर मोर डिटेल्स अबाउट द कॉलेज यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट इन द डिटेल्स प्रोवाइडेड बिलो द स्क्रीन। थैंक यू। सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज लेंस इक्वेशन एंड वी डिराइव लेंस इक्वेशन और नॉन एज लेंस फॉर्मूला फॉर कॉन्वेक्स मिरर प्रोड्यूसिंग रियल इमेज एंड कॉन्वेक्स मिरर प्रोड्यूसिंग वर्चुअल इमेज। सो नाउ इन आवर टुडे डिस्कशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ लेंस इक्वेशन फॉर कॉनकेव मिरर, इट मींस हाउ लेंस इक्वेशन कैन बी डिराइव्ड फॉर ए कॉनकेव लेंस। आई हैव प्रीवियसली टोल्ड दैट कॉन्वेक्स लेंस प्रोड्यूसेस वर्चुअल एज वेल एज रियल इमेज, but it depends on the location of the object. The image sometimes virtual or real in convex lens, it depends on the location of the object on the principal axis. But here in concave lens, we always produce virtual image because the image formed in concave lens does not depend on the location of the object. Anywhere you can place the object and you will got the virtual image. So let's start lens equation for concave lens. Remember that concave lens always produces virtual image. Okay, always produces what? Virtual image. Concave lens always produces virtual image. Virtual image means what? The ray of light originally does not intersect with each other. The real refracted light does not intersect with each other. So the image will be virtual. So let's discuss about lens equation for concave lens. So I have taken a concave lens here having C as its optical center and F as its focus of the lens. Suppose a object is placed beyond F, it means behind F, or you can place the object on F, inside F and C, wherever your wish is. So I place the object beyond F. So AB, AB is an extended object placed beyond F, and AB is perpendicular to the principal axis XY. So here XY is the principal axis and C is the optical center, F is the focus. Now a ray of light coming parallel to the principal axis and incident in the lens. Suppose a ray of light AM going parallel to the principal axis and incident at a point M, and concave lens is also known as diverging lens. It will diverge the ray of light here. Suppose this is MT, the parallel ray of light coming from A, incident at M, and it diverges the ray of light towards T. So if I backtrace the parallel ray of light after refraction go through the focus, if I backtrace the path of the light, it will be the focus. Okay, it will be the focus. And another ray of light incident through the optical center will go undeviated. Okay, it will go undeviated, and these two refracted light meet each other at the point A dash. Okay, so A dash, the ray of light AM and AC after intersecting at A dash will be the image of point A. A dash will be the point, A dash will be the point that is the image point of the point A. So if A is perpendicular to B, now this point is A dash. If I draw a perpendicular to principal axis, this point will be B dash. So A, B dash, A dash, B dash will be the image, and A, B is the object. A dash, B dash is the virtual image of object A, B. So let's derive the lens equation. Now look, triangle A, B, C and A dash, B dash, C. Triangle A, B, C is similar with triangle A dash, B dash, C. A, B, C triangle is similar with A dash, B dash, C. Because this is 90 degree, B dash is also 90 degree. This is a common angle, so that this angle will be equal to that angle. So angle angle similarity, so that these two triangles are similar. If they are similar, I can write height upper height. It means AB by A dash B dash is equals to BC divided by B dash C. Height by height equals to base upon base. Mark it equation 1. Got it? Now look the triangle MCF and A dash B dash F. Triangle MCF and triangle A dash B dash F. MCF and B dash A dash F. MCF and A dash B dash F. This is 90 degree. This will be 90 degree. This is a common angle. So this angle will be equals to this angle. So again, angle similarity, that is A similarity. So that these two triangles are similar. If these two triangles are similar, you can find height upper height. It means MC by A dash B dash is equals to CF by B dash F. CF by B dash F. Now the length of MC, is similar with AB, so that I can write AB by A dash B dash is equals to CF by B dash F. Mark it equation 2. But my point, MC, because MC is equal to what? AB. So that in place of MC, I have written AB. So now look at equation 1 and 2. In equation 1 and 2, the LHS are equal. If the LHS are equal in two equations, then the RHS will be equal. So from equation 1 and 2, what we got? We got the RHS are equal. It means BC upon B dash C is equals to CF upon B dash F. Got my point? So now we can write BC by B dash C is equals to CF by B dash F. This B dash F can be found and can be written as CF minus CB dash. CF minus B dash C. CF minus B dash C, then it will be B dash F. Got my point? So mark it equation 3. Now transform the geometrical length into optical length. That is BC is equals to what? BC is equals to object distance, and it will be minus U BC. Then B dash C, it will be of image distance minus B. CF, focal length, and it will be minus F. CF, it will be minus F. Focal length is also always, whenever we talk about focal length, it is about second principal focus. Not that focus plus right side, it will be in the left side. So put these values in equation 3. Put these optical length in equation 3. So BC will be what? Minus U by B dash C minus B is equals to CF minus F by CF minus F minus B dash C, it will be minus B. Got my point? Now solve this. Negative negative will cancel out each other. It remains with U divided by B is equals to what? Minus F divided by minus F plus of B. Minus minus plus, minus F plus B. Now cross multiply this. U whole into minus F plus of B is equals to B into minus F minus B F. What my point? U whole into minus F plus, this is B, okay? This is B is equals to minus B F. This is B. B dash C is minus B. So U whole into minus F, it will be minus U F plus U B is equals to minus B S. After multiplication we will found this. Now mark it equation 4. What? Mark it equation 4. Divide U B F throughout equation 4. Divide U B F throughout equation 4. After dividing U B F, we will found minus U F by U B F is equals to सॉरी प्लस UV डिवाइडेड बाय UVF इज इक्वल्स टू माइनस VF बाय UVF. I have divided UVF throughout the equation. Now UF will cancel out here. It remains with minus 1 by V plus UV UV U by 1 by F. Okay, this will be 1 by F is equals to minus 1 by U. VF, VF will cancel out each other. Got my point? This is the expression. Now, rearrange this. So what will we get? Minus 1 by V plus 1 by U is equals to minus 1 by F. If U comes to this side and F goes to that side, it will be minus 1 by V plus 1 by U is equals to 1 upon F. Take a negative sign common. So it will be what? 1 by V minus 1 by U is equals to 1 upon F. The negative signs in the both side will cancel out each other and it remains with 1 by V minus 1 by U is equals to 1 upon F. That is 1 by V minus 1 by U is equals to 1 upon F. This is the lens equation. This is also derived for convex lens and I here derived from concave lens. So this is the lens equation for concave lens. The image is, look, this image is virtual and erect. Okay. The image is what? Virtual and erect. Virtual and erect. The virtual because we backtrace the path of light, virtually draw this. So it will be a virtual and erect image. And also diminished. The size of the image is smaller than the size of the object. And also it is diminished or smaller size. Diminished. Or you can say smaller size. So this is about lens equation for concave lens. So my dear students, whenever we use a concave or convex lens, it somehow converges or diverges the ray of light after refraction. A convex lens will converge the lens, the ray of light, and a concave lens will diverge the path of the light. So this convergence and divergence will happen only when the ray of light refracted through the lens. So the lens had certain inner characteristics so that it converges or diverges the ray of light. I am going to tell you that the lenses are converged or diverged ray of light after refraction. So why they are converged or refract? What is the characteristics inside the lens that it converges or diverges the ray of light? And this ability of a lens is known as power of a lens. What? Power of a lens. When we go to an optician, he told us that your eye power is negative or your eye power is positive. What is he asking about? So this he is asking about the power of the lens you are going to use in your spectacles. So let's discuss about what is power of a lens. So I am going to erase about, just pause it and copy it. So what? Power of a lens. Power of a lens. Okay, it is denoted by the symbol capital P. In mechanics, we also use P for power. In ray optics also we use P for power. It is here written in capital letter. P for power of a lens. So what is power of a lens? Suppose my dear students, I have considered a convex lens. Okay, it is a convex lens, and there is another convex lens here. Suppose this is also a convex lens. So this will be the principal axis, and this will be the optical center. Here it is the principal axis, and here is the optical center of the lens. Suppose my dear students, a ray of light incident here, and after refraction, it will go through the focus, and it is passed through the focus. Okay, the similar ray of light incident on the lens at a point, and after refraction, it will also converge this, and this will be the focus, because parallel ray of light after refraction go through the focus. So now, if the ray of light does not converge at the point M, or I can say if the ray of light does not bend at the point M, it will go like this, and here it will go like this, travel like this. So now look this angle and to this angle. Compare these two angles. If these two angles, clearly it is visible that this angle of deviation, this is what? Angle of deviation. The incident ray, this is the refracted ray. That deviation is the this angle, or I can say here this angle. So in these two angles, this angle is clearly greater than that of this angle. So here, suppose the ray of light bent by 30 degree, here it will be 60 degree. So I can say this lens is more deviate the path of light than this lens. Suppose this is lens 1, this is lens 2. So I can say lens 2 bend the ray of light by more angle than that of the lens 1, because lens 1 deviate the path of light by 30 degree. But in lens 2 it is deviated the path of light by 60 degree. Now look for the focal length. This will be the focal length, and here it is the focal length. Okay, so now look, the angle of deviation is more or less? It is less. This is 30, this is 60. So this is angle of deviation is less, focal length is more. The angle of deviation is more, focal length is short. Got my point? The deviation is less, focal length is more. Deviation is more, focal length is less. So it is clearly seen that the power of a lens, it bends the ray of light. So this has got ability that is known as power. So I can say power of a lens is the reciprocal of focal length. Power of the lens is reciprocal of focal length. It means power of lens is inversely proportional to focal length. If focal length increases, power will be decreased. If focal length decreases, power will be more. In this two figure, you can see this thing. So what is the definition of power? So let's discuss about what is the definition of power. So the definition is power of a lens, it is P. Power of a lens P is defined as the tangent of the angle by which it converges or diverges. Converge or diverge. Diverge in case of what? Concave lens, and converge in convex lens. Got my point? Converge or diverge, angle by which it converge or diverge, the ray of light incident incident at unit distance from the optical center C. From the optical center C. Part the definition describes. It is power of a lens P is defined as the tangent of the angle by which it converges for convex lens or diverges for concave lens. The ray of light incident at unit distance from the optical center. So what it means? Let's discuss about this. What it means? So my dear students, suppose I consider a convex lens. What my point? I have considered a convex lens and this is the optical center C. And this is the ray of light going coming parallel and incident at point at this point is suppose M. But my point, it incident at the point M. The ray of light coming parallel after refraction it will go through the focus. So it will be what? CF will be the focal length. So my dear students, if I extend the path of the light, it will be like this and these two lines are parallel to each other because the ray of light coming parallel to the principal axis. Suppose this angle is delta. It means the angle of deviation is delta. And these two lines are parallel to each other and this is their interceptor. If this is delta, this will be delta. Yes or no? This is delta, then it will be delta because the alternate angles are equal. If this is delta, it will be equal. These two lines are parallel and this is their intersector. If this is the angle of deviation delta, then it will be angle of deviation delta. So, the power of the lens is defined as the tangent of the angle of deviation. I got my point? The tangent of the angle of deviation. Tangent means what? What? The ratio, the trigonometric ratio tan delta. Tangent means tan. So, the power of the lens is what? The tangent of the angle of deviation. And suppose this distance is what? C to M is 1 unit. But my point? Here I have written incident at unit distance from the optical center. This is optical center and this is 1 unit distance. Then this definition will be verified. So, my dear students, if this is delta, then this will be delta. Got my point? Now look, if MCF, it is a right angle triangle, MCF, this is M, this is C, this is F, and this angle is what? Delta. If I want to find what is delta, then I have to consider tan delta. So tangent of delta will be what? This is delta, this will be P, this will be B, this will be H. So tan theta will be what? P divided by B. So if I want to find tan delta here, it will be tan delta is equals to P by B, it means MC by CF. MC divided by CF. Then tan delta is equals to MC. MC means how much is the distance? This is 1 unit, or you can here write 1 divided by CF. CF is the focal length. So tan delta is 1 by f and I have written here the tangent of the deviation is known as power. So here tan delta is equal to what? Power. P is equal to 1 upon f. P is equal to what? 1 upon f. What my point? P is equal to 1 upon f. I have already discussed that how P is the reciprocal of focal length. Or I can say how P is inversely proportional to it. If focal length increases, the power will be decreased. If focal length decreases, the power will be increased. So P is equal to 1 upon F. So this is the concept of power of a lens. Suppose I want to find the SI unit of power. The SI unit of power is diopter. What? Diopter. The SI unit of power. What? Diopter. D-I-O. P-T-E-R, diopter, or you can simply write a capital D. Capital D means also diopter. Or you can say this is 1 and this is F. Length SI unit is meter, or you can say meter inverse. What? Meter inverse. Meter inverse is same as diopter. Got my point? And remember that, my dear students, focal length is always measured in meter. What? Focal length is always measured in meter so that the power will be measured in diopter. Focal length, if there is a question and it is given that focal length is in centimeter, then you have to convert the centimeter or millimeter into first meter, then calculate the power of the lens and you will got the unit diopter. But my point, focal length is always measured in meter. I am going to write focal length always measured in meter. Always measured in meter. Focal length is always measured in meter. So this is power of a lens. So my question is that power of a lens, clearly I can see it depends on the focal length. Power of a lens depends on focal length. If focal length is positive, then power will be what? If focal length is positive, then power will be what? Power will be also positive. If focal length is negative, the power will be automatically, it will be negative. If focal length is positive, it will be positive. If it is negative, it will be negative. So what it claims? It claims that if focal length is positive, in which type of lens focal length is positive? In convex lens. Okay? If focal length is positive, it means convex lens. Which lens? Convex lens. So I can say the power of a convex lens is always positive. Because the focal length of a convex lens is always positive. The focal length of a lens is negative, so that power is negative. The focal length is negative in which lens? It is a concave lens. It is a concave lens. So concave lens always have the negative power and have the negative focal length, and convex lens has the positive focal power because it has positive focal length. So let's understand it with a practical example that happens in our life. Suppose you go to an optician and he prescribes you need a plus 2.5 diopter spectacles. Okay, so what is plus? The plus sign indicates you need a convex lens. But my point, suppose the doctor asks you to use plus 2.5 diopter spectacle, it means the doctor is asking that you should use a convex lens. And suppose another patient go to the doctor and he says you should use minus 1 diopter lens. So it means the optician or the doctor is prescribing a convex lens of power 1 diopter. The positive and negative sign just signifies that which type of lens and the magnitude here written is the power of the lens. The sign defines the types of lens, the magnitude defines the power of the lens. So today, in today's class, we have discussed about concave lens producing virtual image and how lens equation, or I can say lens formula, can be derived from concave lens. And after concave lens, we have discussed about the basic concept of power. So my dear students, there in certain books it is only written that the power of a lens is the reciprocal of focal length. So you should not write like this, P is equal to 1 by L. This is a poor method, I say. So you have to write what I have written here. This is the basic condition of power and concept of power. You should not only write P equals to 1 by L. You should derive here. For 2 marks, it asks in CHSE exam, briefly discuss about power of a lens. You just write that P is equal to 1 by F and F is meter and P is unit diopter. You should not write like this. You should write like this. This definition and this derivation, and after that this unit. But my point, for any doubt and any clarification about physics, ask me on the comment box. Thank you.